Today, we're going to talk about inductive proofs of three fundamental identities that are used in calculus. They're all used when we're trying to compute sums, Riemann sums. And the three fundamental identities are the summation j equal 1 to n of j, that would be 1 plus 2 plus blah, 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 plus n. We can write that as n times n plus 1 over 2. You can think about these as bowling pin numbers. It's the way you would arrange bowling pins in a very large bowling hall. We have the sum from j equal 1 to n of j squared. That would be 1 squared plus 2 squared plus blah, 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 plus n squared. That's going to be equal to n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6. And our last identity is the sum from j equal 1 to n of j cubed is equal to 1 cubed plus 2 cubed plus blah, 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 plus n cubed. And that's going to be equal to n times n plus 1 over 2 squared. There are formulas for the sums of jth powers. They involve the Bernoulli numbers. The Bernoulli numbers are something that we'll probably cover in another video in a long time in the future. Meanwhile, there are such formulas, and you can define these formulas recursively. It's a fun thing to try to do, but these are the fundamental formulas that we're going to prove today. And the way we're going to prove it is by proof by induction. So I want you to think about probably one of the most popular videos that's out there in the current month, which is an OK Go video where we start out with a truck and it's pushing over a bunch of dominoes. So these are dominoes. And what we know about dominoes is if the kth domino falls, then the k plus first domino falls. So if the kth domino falls, the k plus first one will fall. But that's not enough to start off the machine. What you have to do is have the first domino fall. In this case, all the dominoes will fall. So we're going to use this domino idea to prove all these identities. So let's look at the first one. The first identity says that the sum from j equal 1 to n of j is equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. And so the first thing that we do is check at n equal 1. So I'm going to write LHS for the left-hand side, and then I'm going to put a 1. So this is the left-hand side at 1. The left-hand side at 1 is the sum from j equal 1 to 1 of j, and there's only one thing that could mean, namely 1. The right-hand side at 1, well, we have to compute that's going to be 1 times 1 plus 1 over 2. That's also equal to 1. So the left-hand side at 1 is equal to the right-hand side at 1. And so, therefore, this statement is true at n equal 1. Now, let's suppose that sum from j equal 1 to n of j is equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. And now we'll use this to show that the sum from j equal 1 to n plus 1 of j is equal to n plus 1 times n plus 2 over 2. So this is what we know is true, that which we're supposing. So we take the sum from j equal 1 to n of j. We know that's equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. And we're going to add an n plus 1 to both sides of this equation. And on the left-hand side, we get the sum from j equal 1 to n plus 1 of j. And on the right-hand side, you may be tempted to multiply this out, but you don't want to multiply it out. What you want to do is you want to factor out the n plus 1. You get n plus 1 times n over 2 plus 1. So that's going to be n plus 1 times n plus 2 all over 2. And that's what you were trying to show, so this identity holds. Now let's look at the next identity. We want to show sum from j equal 1 to n of j squared is equal to n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6. And at n equal 1, the left-hand side is just going to be equal to the sum from j equal 1 to 1 of 1 squared. That's going to be equal to 1. The right-hand side, well, we got to work this thing out, is going to be 1 times 2 times 3 over 6, so that's also equal to 1. So it's true at n equal 1. And we're going to suppose this to show the next step. So we're going to take sum from j equal 1 to n of j squared. We suppose that that's equal to n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6 plus n plus 1 squared. We'll add an n plus 1 squared to the right. And let's factor out an n plus 1 over 6. And what we're left with is going to be n times 2n plus 1. And then plus 6 times n plus 1. And this should be n plus 1 over 6. We'll multiply this out. We get 2n squared plus 7n plus 6. And then when we factor, we're going to get n plus 1 times n plus 2 times 2n plus 3. And that indeed is what we were trying to show, that this quantity is equal to. I skipped a couple of steps. Now let's go over to the last one. I'm going to skip the step where we show that the left-hand side at 1 is equal to the right-hand side at 1. I'll leave that to the viewer. Meanwhile, I'm going to suppose that the sum from j equal 1 to n of j cubed is equal to n times n plus 1 over 2 quantity squared. I'm going to add in an n plus 1 cubed to both sides of that equation. Then I'm going to factor an n plus 1 squared over 2 out of both these terms. That's going to leave me with an n squared plus 2n plus 1. And that's 2n plus 2, excuse me, 2n plus 2. So this is going to be n plus 1 squared times n plus 2 squared over 4. And that's the right-hand side of what we were trying to show. And so that is a sketch of the proof that all these three identities hold.